the background is that I that my lawyer for matters I was handling had handled the underlying civil litigation. I had nothing to do with the criminal litigation where he was exonerated, but handled a civil litigation out of which a $33 million judgment came and basically was overwhelming against Mr. Simpson. He didn't have that kind of money, and so we tried to make some deals. We got hired to basically effectively defend against a very, very aggressive attack from an attorney up in San Francisco, a very, very knowledgeable attorney, a very aggressive attorney, a gentleman named David Cook, who over 20 years has been my adversary in the Simpson matters. We've gone to court probably 40 times trying to save assets, to protect Mr. Simpson's exempted property, protect his golf clubs, protect his clothing, protect some of his trophies. We actually had a fight over the Heisman Trophy, and I saw to it that one of the other parties got the Heisman Trophy other than the opposition, because the opposition said they would not sit down at a table with us and negotiate a deal, but rather, and this was Mr. Goldman saying, I'd rather walk down Wilshire Boulevard with the Heisman Trophy on top of my head than to ever do business with Mr. Goldman. Regrettably, that has led to him 20 years later having gotten very, very little money. If he had decided to work with us, we are willing and we're willing to sit down and, if you will, try and compensate him and his family for the tragedies, irrespective of who did what to whom. We've worked closely with Mr. Simpson. He has become a very well-respected citizen in Las Vegas, very well-liked. He served 9 years in prison for a crime that really was not or should not have been that gravely punished. But of course, the judge there was thinking back to the original set of circumstances for which he had been exonerated. And quite frankly, that was very unfair. We're doing our best to see if we can't work closely with Mr. Cook to develop a deal whereby everybody benefits out of the potential earning power of Mr. Simpson. But we're not going to let them come in and raid our ability to earn a living for Mr. Simpson. And we're in negotiations talking about this, have been for the past 18 months. Hopefully we'll have something in this year to share with the American public.